Before we start working with fractions, let's look at this problem and think about how we're going to be using division and tape diagrams. We have how many cups are needed for one cake when we have this information. When I see that question, how many cups are needed for one cake, I'm asking how much in each group. Here, the group is a cake. One cake is one group. And I want to know how many cups of flour do I need for just one cake? It is helpful to think about this tape diagram and think about the two things that I'm representing. First off, all of this is the 15 cups. That's the 15 cups right there, because all of this is the three cakes. But I'm only really interested in one cake. But that's really easy to figure out. If I'm only interested in one cake, and I've got 15 cups spread among the three cakes, that is pretty easy to divide up. That is 5 cups there, 5 cups there, 5 cups there. That's it. Our answer is we need 5 cups for one cake. And if I can fit that in, we have 15 divided by 3 equals 5. We just solved a problem. We were trying to figure out how much is in each group, how many cups of flour in each cake. Let's do another problem like that with fraction division. Now things are a little different. Alexandra has 2 cups of blueberries, which is enough for 4/5. There's our fraction of the cake. How much does she need for the whole cake? Please notice that the entire piece of tape is the whole cake. What I need to be thinking about is how I want to label pieces of this. So for example, I'm looking for 4/5 of the cake. That right there is 4/5 of the cake. 4 out of the 5 rectangles. 4/5 of the cake. But I also know I have 2 cups of blueberries. So that's what the 4/5 corresponds to. I've got 2 cups here. So what I'm trying to think about is, all right, for 2 cups, that was 4/5 of the cake. How much do I need for all of the cake? It's helpful to think about that I've got 2 cups here, and I've got 4 rectangles or pieces of the cake here. 2 divided up into 4 pieces is 2/4 or 1/2. So right here I have 1/2 of a cup, and that's true all the way across. That's also going to be true for the last rectangle because I broke this up into equal pieces. And now I have an answer. For the entire cake, I need all of these cups. So my answer is going to be that she needs 5/2 cups, or if you want to think of it as 2.5 cups, for the entire cake. If I want to think of this as a fraction problem, what I did is I took 2 divided by 4/5, and I got 5/2, which is also equal to 2.5. To review, it was really important. I knew that I started off with 4/5 of the cake. That's 4 out of the 5 rectangles in my tape diagram. And that was equal to 2 cups of blueberries, right here. I could see that if I split up my 2 cups of blueberries into 1, 2, 3, 4 equal pieces, I would have 1/2 cup in each piece. And so I have 1/2 cup in the last part of my tape diagram. Putting that all together, that is 5/2 cups, or 2.5 cups.